Good afternoon to all of you. So myself Sridhar Babu, working as associate professor from Tributary Department. So today I am going to explain about some basic concepts in power electronics. So basically, what is meant by power electronics? What is the definition of power electronics? Here the definition is as follows. So by using electronic devices, we are going to control the power in terms of voltage and current. So that's why here the meaning comes as power electronics. By using the electronic devices, we are going to control the power in terms of voltage and current. Here, these electronic devices, later we are going to call it as solid state devices, right? So immediately, so what are those solid state devices we have? So here we have one family that is called as thyristor family. So here, so what is meant by thyristor family? Here, the name which is given to the power semiconductor devices. Are called as thyristor family. In that, we have the first member is SCR. SCR means silicon controlled rectifier. Silicon control rectifier. Next followed by BJT. BJT stands for bipolar junction transistor. Next MOSFET. So which is called as metal oxide semiconductor field level transistor. Next fourth one IGBT. Which is called as insulated gate bipolar transistor. Next, another one is IGCT, that is insulated gate commutator transistor. Next, ZTO, etc. So all these are the power semiconductor devices which are comes under this thyristor family. Here, especially in power electronics, we are going to study all these devices characteristics. SCR, BJT, MOSFET, IGBT, etc. etc. They characteristics. It means VI characteristics. So that is about the thyristor family. Next, coming to the SCR. Why? Because in power electronics, our main focus is on SCR. So SCR stands for silicon control rectifier. So why it is called silicon control rectifier means which is made up of silicon material for rectification purpose. That's why it is called as silicon control rectifier. Its symbol will be like this, which is almost similar to diode. The only difference is gate terminal, anode, cathode. So it is having three terminals. This here is having three terminals. What are those? Anode, cathode, and gate. So these three are the terminals for SCR. So if I compare with respect to diode, which is similar to SCR, the only difference is gate terminal. So that's why this is called as uncontrolled device. Why? Because it doesn't have any control terminal, which is called as uncontrolled device. Whereas SCR is a controlled device. Why? Because it is having a controlled terminal which will controls the output by providing the gate pulse across gate and cathode terminals. Right. Next, it's construction. SCR construction, I will show you. So, which is a four layer, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 layer PNPN device. So anode, cathode, and gate. Right. So this is its construction, which is having three junctions J1, J2, and J3. This is a construction. So this one will be the symbol of LCR, anode, cathode. Right. So here, by using these devices, we are going to construct the circuits in power electronics, which are called as power electronic converter circuits. Which are called as power electronic converter circuits. By using these devices like SCR, power electronic converter circuits. So what are those means? There is a classification. The first one is AC to DC converter. Second one is DC to AC converter. Third one is DC to DC converter. And fourth one is AC to AC converter. AC to AC converter. Here AC to DC converter, DC to AC converter, DC to DC and AC to AC means, here the input, let us consider this one. Here the input is AC, output is DC. By giving input as a fixed DC to the circuit, we are going to get a DC as an output. So which is called as a phase controlled rectifier. Phase controlled rectifier. The AC to DC converter is also called as a phase controlled rectifier. So depends upon the input supply. Suppose if we have a single phase AC supply as input, so here we have the classification like this: single phase, half wave, controlled rectifier circuit, rectifier. Next, single phase, full wave, controlled rectifier circuit. Third one is single phase semiconductor. Means it's a combination of SCRs and diodes. Right. Suppose if the input supply is three phase AC supply, the same classification whatever we have considered for single phase, that is three phase, half wave, controlled rectifier circuit. Controlled rectifier circuit. Next, second one, three phase, full wave, controlled rectifier circuit. And third one is three phase, semiconductor. So, this is a classification about the phase controlled rectifiers. Right, next. DC to AC converter. Here the input is DC and output is AC. So this DC to AC converter is also called as input. Next. So again we have the inverter classification. That is a single phase inverter. Next to three phase inverters. Like whatever we have with classification with respect to phase control rectifier. Here also we have the single phase, series inverter, parallel inverter, next three phase inverter. Right. Next DC to DC converter. So it means here the input is a fixed DC, output is a variable DC. It means from fixed DC to variable DC. So which is called as a chopper. Which is called as a chopper. Right. Which is of DC equivalent of transformer. Well, because here the transformer, the classification of transformer is which is similar to the chopper. So in transformers we have the classification step up transformer, step down transformer. Here we have a chopper classification is like that. We have a step down and step up. which is similar to your transformer classification. Right. Here also we have the relation between output voltage and input voltage. If the output voltage V naught is stepped down, it means your source is getting dominated. It means if V naught is less than Vs, that is output voltage is less than the source voltage, which is called a step down transformer. If V naught is greater than Vs, it means if the load is dominating the source, which is called a step up transformer. Right. So that is about the transformer classification. Next to the final, we have an AC to AC converter. Here the input is fixed AC and the output is a variable AC. That is, in terms of voltage, we have a AC voltage regulator or controller. AC voltage regulator or controller. So that is in terms of voltages. In terms of frequency, we have the class again, that is cycloconverter. Cycloconverter means which converts a fixed frequency to variable frequency, which is other than the frequency, which is called as cycloconverter, that is fixed frequency to variable frequency. Here also we have the classification like your choppers. Step up, cycloconverter, step down, cycloconverter. Here we are going to consider the frequencies, output frequency versus input frequency. If the output frequency is greater than the supply frequency or input frequency, we are going to call as step down cycloconverter. Step up means your output frequency is lower than the supply frequency. So that is about the power electronic converter circuits. That is AC to DC converter, next to DC to AC converter, next to DC to DC converter, and last one is AC to AC converter. Right. So and one more thing is as I've told you regarding that we are using SCRs as the switches in the circuit. With that we are going to construct the power electronic circuit. It means those SCRs will act like the switches. Right. So here we need to switch on and switch off this SCR. Right. So it means in order to turn on the SCR, it has to satisfy some requirements. So what are those requirements? It should be forward biased. It should be forward biased. That is, average positive with respect to cathode. Next, the gate pulse should be applied. Gate pulse should be applied between gate and cathode terminals. Between gate and cathode terminals. Then only your SCR or the switch is going to be on. Similarly, the device is going to be off. Here in power electronics, off means commutation. That will be defined as, that is redefined as commutation. Right. So what are the requirements for this? Here it should be reverse biased. It should be reverse biased. And second one is gate pulse should be removed. Gate pulse should be removed. Then only that device is going to be off or commutation. So here commutation, we have again there is a classification, line or natural commutation. Next, second one is force commutation. So what is meant by line or natural commutation means the supply itself acts like a reverse voltage under the reverse biasing condition. Under the reverse biasing condition, Vs will act like a reverse voltage. It means with that reverse voltage we are going to off the SCR. Right. Next, forceful commutation. In that moment, there is a meaning. Forcibly, we are going to turn off the device. So here, by using some external circuit or auxiliary circuits, we are going to turn off the SCR. That is about the forceful commutation. Here we have the classification like the class A, class B, class C, class D, and class E and class F. So these are the forceful commutation circuits. So it means by using some external circuit, we are going to turn off the main SCR which is in the circuit. So that is about the forceful commutation. Line commutation means there is no need of any external circuit. With that, we are going to turn off the device. Thank you.